Please note that some events in this book trailer were skipped to make it a bit more interesting. A black wind was shrieking across the bleak little island of Burke. Furious thunder boomed overhead. Lightning speared the water. Only a madman would think it was the kind of weather for a pleasant sail. But amazingly, there was one ship being hurled violently from wave to wave. The madman in charge of this ship was Gobber the Belch. Gobber ran the pirate training program on the Isle of Burke, and this crazy voyage was, in fact, one of Gobber's lessons, sword fighting at sea, beginners only. Remember when I said that the ship on the wave was part of the lesson of sword fighting at sea? Well, for the sword fighting, Gobber picked one of the toughest, meanest boys in the boat, who was named Dog's Breath. Hiccup was picked among the other boys to fight him. Just when Hiccup thought he was going to get killed, because the wooden sheath came off Dog's Breath's sword and he didn't care, the boat capsized and everyone fell off. Except the dragons, they flew away. The green boy is Hiccup, the red boy is Dog's Breath, and the brown triangle is the wooden sheath. The Vikings were thrown off the boat and into the sea. The thing that capsized the boat was a black box that the meatheads had thrown. Hiccup clung to the black box until he and the other Vikings got to the shore. When they did, they found that the black box was actually Grimbeard the Ghastly's coffin. They brought it to the Viking hall and everybody else, except Old Wrinkly, Hiccup, and Fishlegs, wanted to open it. When the men came out and led them to the Isle of the Scullions using a map and a riddle. The scullions were untrainable dragons who would handicap you and eat you. Meanwhile, a small dragon was wandering around looking for its mom. It went in the wrong direction and it was frightened. A monster in the darkness reached out with a tentacle near the little dragon, with a prick filled with poisonous green gas. It punctured the little dragon with it, killing it and ate it. Will Hiccup survive the Isle of the Scullions? Will he find the treasure and become a hero? Read How to Train Your Dragon Book 2, How to Be a Pirate by Cressidia Cowell to find out. Created with work by Kayla Serrano and Nisha Agrawala. Intended for audiences 8 and above because of certain death and tough scenes. The genres of this book are children's literature and fantasy fiction. We recommend this book because of the danger, adventure, and dragons. Please give credit to the people who made the icons and background images, whom we don't know. Thank you.